Jason Hamilton shows why any loved one wearing a fur coat has to be protected from this heat.
Tonight, NewsLight's Karen Johnson was there for the rescue and also has tips on avoiding a pet crisis of your own.
Can you carry it?
I got her.
All right.
An unconscious pit bull, barely breathing, rushed to the vet.
They said she might be pregnant right now.
She's collapsed, helpless, hooked up to an IV immediately.
There we go. We're good.
Cold fluids drip into her body. Pulse is checked. Animal control officers still not sure if the dog is going to make it.
You know, they have fur coats no matter what. Even if it's the shortest of coats at 90 to 100 degrees, they're going to respond to the heat.
And if left in the heat too long, this is what could happen. The dog warden says a Hamilton family left the pit bull outside all afternoon with only a piece of cardboard on top of concrete to sit on. Neglect may have led to this dog's injuries, but animal control officers say in this weather, they're seeing many dogs suffer from heat exhaustion because people simply don't know any better. Yesterday, a dog in this area died because it was tethered and got stuck in the sun. Placement of a doghouse, also important.
If they have a doghouse, if it's on dirt, it's going to be better than if it's on cement or a hard surface because it will harbor the heat inside the doghouse if it's not on dirt.
And whether your dog is outside or inside, they need cold water.
There are some cases where dogs won't even drink hot water because it doesn't really do them anything. It's not really to keep them hydrated. It's more to bring their temperature down.
If you notice your dog panting heavily, getting lethargic, or becoming unresponsive like this pit bull, you should put wet towels on their head and feet and call your vet immediately. In Hamilton, Karen Johnson.